students. Now, let's move towards our exercises. First part is part C. Match the sentence parts. These are match the columns. At one side, we have been given half statement. At the other side, we have been given the half statement. We have to match the appropriate statements to make a whole sentence. Now, for the first statement, a frog lay an egg. Now, where does a frog lay an egg? We are going to match one with D. The frog lays an egg in the water. The egg hatches in two. Read from the start. Start to grow, an adult, A to breathe, a tadpole. As we have read, the frog egg hatches into a tadpole. So here, you are going to match it with E. In this way, you have to read the first statement and then read the second statement and then match the appropriate statements accordingly. I hope all of you are able to attempt this part. Now, moving towards our next question. So students, now our part B. Write the sentences in flowchart, the life cycle of a frog. Here, we will have to write the life cycle of a frog. Now, for the first sentence, what are we going to write? What we have read in our part C and in our unit, the frog lays egg in water. So, for the first statement, we are going to write, the frog lays egg in water. For the next one, second statement, the eggs hatch into a tadpole. In this way, you have to complete the life cycle of the frog. What happens next, then next, you have to complete this flowchart. I hope all of you are able to write the life cycle of the frog. You can read again your chapter and understand the life cycle, and then write it in your own words. Now students, moving towards our next part. So students, here we have got our part F. Think about the life cycle of a frog. What other facts do you know about frogs? Now first of all, think about the life cycle of a frog. It's very interesting. What other facts do you know about frogs? I know that frogs can live in land as well as in water. Frogs belong to that group of animals that are able to live in land and they can also swim in water. Frogs are mostly of green color. Frogs can jump. They can take long leaps. In this way, you have to think about some other facts related to frogs and write them here in your part F. Remember, students, you have to attempt this part F on your notebooks. I hope all of you are able to attempt it. Moving towards our next question. So students, now moving towards our part G. I hope you all can see part G here on the book. Now, in this part, you have to think about some other animals that change a lot during their life cycle and then write them down here. Now, I know that butterfly changes a lot in their life cycle. So first, I'm going to write about butterfly. Other animal that changes during the life cycle. A hen also changes during the life cycle. Cats, dogs. So students, in this way, you have to think about the life cycles of other animals and write them down who change a lot during their life cycle. Now, moving towards our next part. So students, here we have got our part H. Now, I hope you all can see your part H on the book. So in this part, you have to write about the life cycle of any animal. You can choose any organism. First of all, as I am choosing a butterfly, so first I am going to write here the life cycle of a butterfly. Then we have been given four questions. You have to attempt those questions accordingly. Now the first question is, how does the animal start its life? Now as you know, the butterfly lays egg. So first I am going to write here, for the first question answer, the butterfly lays eggs. Now, what other changes are happening during their cycle? You have to enlist them, read the question and then attempt them accordingly. As we know, the butterfly lays eggs. Those eggs, from those eggs, a larva comes out. That larva develops into a caterpillar. And then the caterpillar develops some wings and changes into a complete butterfly. In this way, the butterfly repeats its cycle again. You have to read the question and write the answer accordingly. Now students, moving towards our next part. So students, this is our part J. I hope all of you can see your part J that is present on your books as well. Now, in this part J, what you have to do is to write about the life cycle of the animal you have chosen. You can use your work from your previous parts, and then in the blocks you have to draw or glue the picture of that animal. As in my previous part, I have chosen about butterfly. So first part I am going to write here, butterfly lays eggs. Over here, in the block, I will draw the picture of the butterfly that is laying eggs. Then from 1 to 2, we'll move to our second step. The second step is that those eggs hatch into larvae. You're going to write here. Then for the third step, I'm first of all going to draw the picture for the second step. Then move towards the third step. The caterpillar is developed, or the caterpillar comes out, and that caterpillar then develops wings and develops into a complete butterfly. In this way, the life cycle is repeated once again. So students, whatever animal or whichever organism you are choosing, first of all you have to write about it in the first step, that how it lays eggs, then how those eggs hatch, and how the complete organism is developed again. I hope all of you are able to attempt these exercises given in your assignment. So students, I hope you enjoyed learning about the life cycle of frogs and learning about the life cycle of a new animal. I will meet you next time with another very interesting and amazing video. Until then, take care. Allah Hafiz.